Hello everyone, myself Mitali Jain, and in today's session we will learn about frequency counter. The frequency counter is a test instrument which is basically used to measure frequency and time of repeated digital signal. The application of the frequency counter, as it's used in different data transmission, it is basically used to detect the power of high data transmission systems, and it is also used in radio frequency ranges. So the order code of this apparatus is 17022. So this is our frequency counter. This is the frequency counter of 10 hertz to 1000 megahertz, and its maximum range is 1.5 gigahertz. So this is our frequency counter. This frequency counter has different features such as frequency, period, and equal precision measuring. And you can see that there are three steps for selections, such as there is a function selection button, there is a workstation, and there is a unit, and there is a, you can see that this is the 8 digital LED display. All these functions depends upon single CPU. Now proceeding to its components, so there are two channels. This is channel A and this is channel B. The channel A ranges from 0.01 hertz to 50 megahertz, and channel B ranges from 50 megahertz to 2.4 gigahertz. And as you can see that there, its resolution is basically, resolution depends upon the gate control setting. So this is the gate control setting. So here we can select the maximum and minimum. So this gate time is basically used for continuous variable from 100 ms to 10 s, and this is the display which I have already discussed, that this is a 8 digit display. And after that, at the back end there is a power supply, so we have to connect that. And so now talking about its keys, so as you can see that there are three operations here. So this is function key, this is period key, and this is confirmation key. So function key has three steps. So when we will press the steps, so first step is that it selects the 50 megahertz to 2.4 gigahertz for channel B, and for function second, like step second, it ranges from 2 megahertz to 50 megahertz for channel A input. And its third function is that 0.01 hertz to 2 megahertz ranges input for channel A for indication of kilohertz per second frequency. So the channel function has basically three steps. Two steps are for channel A and B. So through channel B we can select the megahertz range, and through channel A we can select the kilohertz and megahertz range both. Then after that there is a period key. So when we will press the key down, the instrument will enter into a period measure mode. Then after that this is the confirmation key. So when we will press the key down, the instrument will start working according to the preset state. And this is the AC coupling and DC coupling key. So when you will push the button down, so it will select the DC coupling, and when the button is at up, so it will automatically at AC coupling. Then after that this is attenuator key. So we will press the key down for attenuated 20 dB measurement. So push it up for no attenuation. If you want no attenuation, you have to push it up, and if you want attenuation of 20 dB, then you have to press it down. So this is the reset key. If you want, when the instrument is abnormal, so you can press the reset key and take it back to the reset position, its previous position. So these are the all functions of this key. We have also mentioned about the gate, and this we have studied, and these are basically LED indicator. For kilohertz this LED will glow, and for megahertz this LED will glow. This is for frequency and this is for period. Hence this is the whole description for frequency counter. Understand this apparatus, we will use this function generator which is of 10 megahertz. So now first of all you have to switch on the supply. So as you can see that our function counter has been started. Then after that we will here set the frequency to 10 kilohertz and set this to kilohertz setting. So for that first of all we have to press the function key. So as I told that there are three functions. So if I would like to select third part, like kilohertz I would want to select, so for that I have to set it to this indicator, So for that, before performing the experiment, first of all, we have to connect the BNC to BNC cable. So this is our BNC to BNC cable. So now we have to connect the cable. So this end we have to connect. And as I am using channel 1, so I'll connect this to channel 1. So you can see that I have connected this BNC to BNC cable. Then after that, I'll set here the frequency to kilohertz. So for that, first of all, we have to press the third step. Then you have to press the confirm. So you can see that it automatically came in kilohertz mode. So you can see that after making certain changes, so first of all I set the frequency to 10 kilohertz, then after that I have shown you the process that how we have to select the kilohertz. So I have set here kilohertz. So this is 10 kilohertz and you can see that on this display this is 10 kilohertz. According to gate time you can change its second, so it's basically used to trigger. So if you want to have a fast triggering, so you can set it the gate time. So I have already set that. And now if I increase it to 20 kilohertz, so you can see that it reaches to 20 kilohertz. And similarly, if I want to set it to 100 kilohertz, so you can see that on this display we are able to see 100 kilohertz. So if I want to set it to 500 kilohertz, so you have to wait, it's 500 kilohertz. In similar manner, you can set it to 1 megahertz. So you can see that when I set it to 1 megahertz, so in kilohertz we can see the value. And if you want to see it in megahertz, so you can set through function. So in this, 1 megahertz is equal to 1000 kilohertz. So you can see. So if you want to increase the range, so you can increase the range through function generators, and you can also increase the range through this function counter also. And you can also connect the different devices for which you want to calculate the frequencies and for repeated digital signal. So in this way I have used this function generator. So when I set the 1 megahertz frequency in this, so you can see that this is 1 megahertz. So it shows that these both the systems are working properly, and this through this frequency counter we are able to calculate the frequency of this frequency generator. Hence, this is all about today's session. I hope that we have learned a lot about frequency counter. So for further query, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and you can also refer to our user manual. Thank you.